Hi, I'm Gavin Strassel, UAW archivist at the Walter P. Reuther Library here at Wayne State University, and I'm excited to show you our UAW films here in our cold storage freezer. Why are we in a freezer right now?
Because most of these films are cellulose acetate base. At room temperature, they start to degrade and get that smell of vinegar, which is called vinegar syndrome, so we have to keep them nice and cold so that they don't degrade.
How many movies would you say are in the UAW film reel archives?
I would say over 1,000, and of those, about 50 to 100 have been digitized.
And are most of these made by the UAW?
Yeah, most of them are made by the UAW, although some are AFL-CIO. We also have just some generic labor film here too that's kind of interspersed within the in the films.
What types of researchers are using these reels?
A lot of documentary producers and directors come if they're doing something on Detroit, if they're doing something on labor. Of course, if they're doing something on the UAW, they come and look at this stuff. Even students come in. When the students come in, that's interesting because they don't know how to use film. They're all too young.
Do we know everything that's on every single film in the collection?
Unfortunately, no. There's a ton of hidden gems in here. Just recently, we were able to digitize one film, and it was so appropriate for the recent UAW negotiations. It was Walter Reuther talking tough about the 1961 GM strike, and it was just so appropriate for what was going on. Those are the kind of things that are hidden within all of these little film canisters, and we would love to be able to see everything.